Hey, what's up guys? Steve here. Welcome to my world. This is our second video. Today, what I wanted to talk to you about is something very, very personal, very, very close to my heart, and I don't know if anybody's even covered this. I'm not an internet troller. I don't go looking through loads of YouTube pages and stuff like that. Only the things that I'm interested in. And it's about depression, either bipolar disorder, depression, and fitness, basically. I'll give you a bit of background about this. About 14 years ago, I was diagnosed with type 2 bipolar disorder, which means basically I have a chemical disorder in my brain, and I had a major breakdown. Like I said before, I've been training about 23 years. I've had a great life, guys. I had nothing major. Well, it's just lights in this fucking place. I had nothing major happen to me in my life where, my God, I'm so sad, so depressed. There are people out there that are like that. The reason why I brought this up, and the reason I want to talk about this today, is because The Rock, Dwayne Johnson, went on Oprah the other week, and he said he had 2 bouts of depression. Well, if you suffer depression or you suffer bipolar disorder, you have it, all right? It does go away eventually, but mine is for the rest of my life. I'm on 2 types of medication. I'm on SSRIs and a anti-anxiety. Doesn't mean I'm mental. I went to the doctors. I didn't know what was happening to me. I didn't eat. Slept in my bed for weeks on end. Didn't train, which is hard. All these guys out there know that if you're a training junkie like myself, then it was hard. But I had a really good friend. I was diagnosed with this. Took medication. And it took time to work, but I had a really, really good friend. He lives somewhere else now, named Sirkan, who knew I was absolutely a gym junkie. And he basically came in the house one day, "Steve, you're going to the gym, even if I have to fucking drag you there, and we're gonna get this shit done." And do you know what? It helped. More than any medication, more than anything, I got up off my ass. He dragged me out of bed, and I started training again. And it makes you feel better, all right? You don't have to be a fucking pro bodybuilder. Guys, I'm telling you, and I might ramble a bit, if you suffer depression, if you have an illness like this, you are not alone. I completely understand. And a lot of people, and the one that's sitting over there actually filming this, is quite shocked, because it's an illness that you can't see, taste, touch, or smell, all right? And it's difficult for people that don't have it to just brush it off. "Oh no, you'll get over it. You'll get over it." Well, no. You know, if you see me walking down the street, you wouldn't know that I had this illness. Some days it's still really, really bad. And all y'all are gonna know what's gonna happen now, but there was only a handful of people. I've hit it for years and years and years and years and years. I hit it. And I thought, fuck this, I'm gonna tell people about it, because I don't know if it's been brought up. Now, bodybuilding, fitness, any type of fitness, get up off your ass and go for a walk. If you have this illness and you've had it for a while and you're in a deep, dark fucking place, get up off your ass, get out of bed and go for a walk. I know it seems like a lot. Jesus Christ, I understand. I completely appreciate that. Go for a walk. Take baby steps, because it does work, all right? And I still get bad days. I get really, really bad days. My other half, I'll tell her, "Laura, I'm not very well today." We have a 4-year-old as well. He doesn't know about this. You will now when you're older. Daddy's I have a very, very good support system, and she understands, and then she'll just leave me alone, go through a bit of bouts, and then I'll come back. If I'm really bad, I'll drag my ass to the gym, I'll train, the endorphins pop off, and fuck me, I feel like $1 million. And it does work, guys. All right, really, I'm gonna go right up to this camera. You are not fucking alone. If you need help, I will fucking do my best to come and help you. I can't tell you how much, I can't tell you how much it means to me that I do understand. And I know it's hard. Do something, all right? By lying there doing nothing, by just wallowing in it, and I know it's hard. Get up off your ass and go do something. See a friend, go to the gym, go for a walk. I don't know, go out and party. I didn't do any of that stuff for weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks. And I went to the doctors. I don't know what the fuck was happening. I thought a brain tumor or something like that. You know, I just thought, what the fuck is going on? I had no idea. And the long and short of it is, doctor, I'm gonna name his name, Dr. Oren David, you're retired, I fucking love you to bits, you saved my life. And I said to him, Dave, and he knew what I was like, David, I have a severe problem, man, and I don't know what's going on here. And we did a bunch of blood tests and all that other stuff, and I went and spoke to people, and they said, bipolar disorder. And Dr. Oren said to me, it's completely chemical, nothing to go. And there are people out there that don't suffer that have had a major bout in their life. They've had cancer and they're depressed. They've been in veterans. This is another thing. Veterans. I'm a veteran. I served in the First Gulf War. After that, I was bummed out for a while. I didn't get depressed from that. Some people do see a lot of bad shit and they get depressed, all right? You are not alone. I do completely understand, guys. So I want you to holler at me, subscribe below, holler at me. Just let's have a discussion about this. I'd be more than happy to talk to you about it. We can put an email address up, yeah? You can email me, no fucking spam from whatever, all right? I don't need that shit. And I'll tell you another thing that helped as well. Loads of really good food, eating well, taking loads of fish, I still eat loads of fish and shitloads of it in there. It does help. So if there's anything else I can help you with, you want to have a discussion, we can do another video about it. I would love that. And by me putting this out to people, it's actually helped me, all right? For those that don't understand the illness and gonna be a bunch of fucking haters, go fuck yourselves, I don't care, all right? Yeah, that's about it. If you like it, click subscribe below. Me and my Canadian dude here, there's two Canadians in one place, it's quite good. We're gonna go hit some fucking chest. We'll do a video up for that for you guys as well. And have a great, great, great day. Click subscribe below. Mahalo. See you later.